Hey everybody, welcome to Help Your Math. We're going to continue solving equations by factoring. We've seen a few ways that we can do this, now we're going to get a little more involved with it. Let's try an equation x to the third is equal to, say, 9x. And we see here, the first thing we want to do is set our equation equal to 0. We do that by subtracting 9x from both sides. Now we'll have x to the third minus 9x is equal to 0. Now, we want to simplify this by factoring. What do we have in common here? Well, we just have an x in common. So we'll take that out. Now we have x squared. We distribute that back in. That's x to the third. And we have minus 9 and equals to 0. Now, this isn't fully simplified yet. This still doesn't look the way that it should. We can't really solve this for x as it is right now. Or we can, but not that easily. So let's go a little further with this one. We learned before that there's a formulation method for factoring. We call it the difference of squares is one of them. And that said that a squared minus b squared can be rewritten as a minus b times a plus b. So what we have here, we've got x squared. We'll say that is our a. And we have 9 squared, or 9, that will be equal to our b squared. And we know that 9 can be written as 3 times 3, right? So when we go to set this back up, we can just say that x is equal to, again using this, our a, which is x, minus our b, which is 3, times, again, our a, which is x, plus our b, which is 3. And don't forget to set that equal to 0 again. And now we're just simply solving each one of these for the missing variable. So we've got an x is equal to 0, nothing to do there. Or that x minus 3 equals 0. And add a 3 to both sides. X is equal to 3. Or, lastly, x plus 3 is equal to 0. Subtract 3 from both sides. Have x is equal to negative 3. So we have three possible solutions for this. And finally, what you always want to do, especially when you start getting a lot of possible values, is plug these back in. Just make sure that everything still solves for your equation. 0 to the third equals 9 times 0. 0 does equal 0. When we have 3 to the third equals 9 times 3. That would be 27. It's equal to 27. That works. And we've got negative 3 to the third is equal to 9 times negative 3. This would be equal to negative 27. This would also be equal to negative 27. So it looks like we're good. So again, whenever you have a problem like this, you first want to set the equation equal to 0, simplify that new equation by factoring, and then solve each of the new components for the missing variable. Thank you.